You are watching the series in Molecular Biology, and in this video, we are going to talk about Hershey and Chase experiment and Chargaff's rules. We were talking about the history of events and discovery of genetic material. We talked about the discovery of Frederick Griffith by means of transforming principle in 1928. We also discussed about the biochemical characterization of the transforming principle by Avery, MacLeod and McCarty. And in this video, we are going to talk about the discoveries of Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase by means of Hershey and Chase experiment. And we'll also talk about the Chargaff's rules by Erwin Chargaff before we come to the discussion of the double helical model of DNA. Hershey and Chase experiment. In 1952, Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase gave the unequivocal proof that DNA is the genetic material. They showed that DNA is the genetic material of viruses. Bacteriophage T2 infects E. coli. T2 is made up of DNA, which contains phosphorus, and protein coat or capsid, which contains sulfur. They hypothesized that the functions of DNA and proteins can be found out by labeling them with radioactive tracers. The experiment began by radioactively labeling specific components of phage by growing them in one of the two isotopic medium. One set of viruses were grown in radioactive sulfur, 35S medium, while the other set were grown in radioactive phosphorus, 32-phosphorus. Phages grown in radioactive sulfur had radio-labeled proteins, and phages grown in radioactive phosphorus had radio-labeled DNA. The viruses were then allowed to infect bacterium, that is E. coli. These bacterial cells were then agitated in a blender to break the contact between viruses and bacteria. So as you can see here, in the first set, we have protein coats labeled radio-labeled. The bacteria are infected with the bacteriophages, and we see that after the blending, we see that no radioactivity enters the cells. While in the second case, the phage DNA is radio-labeled, the bacteria are infected with the phages, and we finally see the radioactivity enters the cells because the DNA is radio-labeled. Then the virus and bacteria were separated via centrifugation. During centrifugation, the larger bacteria formed a solid pellet at the bottom while the smaller viruses remained in the supernatant. The bacterial pellet of sample infected with radioactive phosphorus phages was found to be radioactive, but not the radioactive sulfur phages. So as you can see, after centrifugation, the radioactivity is observed in the supernatant because the protein was radio-labeled. While in the second case, after centrifugation, we see radioactivity in pellet because the DNA was radio-labeled. So conclusion is that proteins are not the genetic material and DNA is the genetic material. This indicated that proteins did not enter the bacteria from the viruses, thus confirmed that DNA, not protein, was the genetic material. Let's come to Chargaff's rules. Discovery of DNA in 1953 by James Watson and Francis Crick would never have been reached groundbreaking conclusion without the scientific foundation provided by many pioneers. Erwin Chargaff was one of those handful of scientists. Chargaff was interested in the base composition of DNA. Between 1944 and 53, he used various chromatographic methods to separate and quantify the relative amounts of the four bases found in the DNA. The four bases are purines and pyrimidines. Pyrimidines include cytosine and thymine, and purines include guanine and adenine. He showed that DNA isolated from different cells of a given species have the same percentages of each of the four bases. He proposed two rules in his lifetime. First and best known, the number of guanine units equals the number of cytosine units, and the number of adenine units equals the number of thymine units. So A equals T and C equals G. Second, the ratio of pyrimidines and purines is equal to 1. So C plus T upon A plus G equals 1. The composition of DNA varies from one species to another, in particular in the relative amounts of A, G, T and C bases. So this became the basis for understanding the structure of DNA, which we are going to see in the upcoming video. Thank you. In the upcoming video, we are going to talk about the structure of DNA discovered by James Watson and Francis Crick. If you found this video informative, please like, subscribe and share. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook. And for any queries or suggestions, please write to us at the given email address. Thank you.